Our distinguished guest, Dr. Kanayo Francis Felix Nwanze, President of the International Fund for Agricultural Development, and delegates. The Director General of AfricaRice, Dr. Harold Roy Macaulay, and members of the EMC. Colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a great honor and privilege for me to represent the women of AfricaRice and speak on their behalf on this auspicious occasion, marking the first visit of the IFAD president to the AfricaRice headquarters in Abidjan on the special day of the year, International Women's Day. When we celebrate and show appreciation for all women around the world, institutions big and small all over the world, including AfricaRice in Benin, Senegal, Tanzania, Nigeria, Sierra Leone, Liberia, Madagascar, and Côte d'Ivoire, are galvanized and come together on this day to recognize the accomplishment of women and to congratulate them on their achievements. The campaign theme for this year's 2016 International Women's Day is Pledge for Parity. We are calling on everyone here, men and women, each in our own spheres of influence, to commit to taking pragmatic action to accelerate gender parity. What we are calling for today are five themes. We are urging you to pledge to help women and girls achieve their ambitions. That is, we should all encourage the women and girls in our lives, in your lives, to reach out for their full potential. Secondly, we urge you to pledge for gender balanced leadership. That is, in your positions of leadership, give women the opportunity to lead. Thirdly, we pledge to value women's and men's contributions equally. That is, we respect the differences with men. Fourthly, we urge you to pledge inclusive, flexible cultures. That is, you should nurture both at home and in the work environment a place which recognizes our needs. Fifthly and lastly, we urge you to pledge to challenge conscious and unconscious bias. That is, we should all strive to root out at workplace and at home bias and help women to advance to higher positions. The International Women's Day of 2016 is extra special because we have in our midst the presence of one of the most distinguished and illustrious sons of Africa, Dr. Nwanze, coming back home to celebrate this day with us. Dr. Kanayo Felix Nwanze Akwaba, we are thankful for your visit to AfricaRice at a stage where we are in a transition from Cotonou, Benin to Abidjan. AfricaRice is very proud and honored to be associated with and working closely in partnership with your institution. On your behalf, on behalf of all the women of AfricaRice, I wish to seize this unique opportunity to acknowledge the significant strides made by IFAD under your able and distinguished leadership. We wish to put on record the achievements of IFAD, which suggests that women from developing world cannot have a better patron to champion the cause of parity for women. Distinguished guests, colleagues, and my dear sisters, let me take a little time to also acknowledge the important strides made by the Director General of AfricaRice, Dr. Harold Roy Macaulay, who responded to the concerns of gender inclusiveness and parity. AfricaRice has a gender action plan which is progressing very well, and the Board of Trustees have set a target of a minimum of 30% employment of female scientists by the year 2018. Presently, under the leadership of Dr. Harold Macaulay, we have 68 female staff and 10 are in managerial positions. We celebrate the appointment of Dr. Rita Agbo Naomashi as country representative heading the AfricaRice Cotonou Station. This is the third time in the history of AfricaRice that a woman is leading an outstation. We thank you, Dr. Roy Macaulay, for this groundbreaking decision. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I wish to acknowledge that the African Union Declaration of the years 2010 to 2020 as the African Women's Decade is to accelerate the implementation of the education-focused Dakar Framework for Action and the Gender Equality-focused Beijing Declaration. As we celebrate this 2016 Women's Day, we recognize the global effort to lift our women folk from the challenges that still remain. The 2014 World Bank report, together with the One Campaign, revealed deep-rooted gender gaps in African agriculture and pointed out the dramatic differences between how men and women farmers in six African countries produce, whereby factors are identified to show what holds women farmers back. It is a pity that women, who constitute almost half of the agricultural workforce across the continent, are still lagging behind, even though there is no time to list them the challenges they face. But in conclusion, if women are given equal access to production resources and the existence of policy interventions, then, such as securing land rights, women farmers could increase the farm yields by as much as 30%, meaning 100 to 150 million fewer people globally going to bed hungry. So, dear ladies and gentlemen, I would like to remind this gathering that despite all the hard work and the dedication of the numerous institutions trying to empower women, we still face challenges and we have miles to go before we reach our final destination. That is why we, the women of AfricaRice, want all those present here, including the IFA Director, President and AfricaRice Director General, to pledge for parity and work towards giving half of humanity the chance. Let us all pledge to value our women and men's contribution equally, and to reflect this in our homes, in our offices, and in our communities. I want to say loud and clear, we all step it up for gender equality as we pledge for gender parity here at AfricaRice, at IFAD, and in Côte d'Ivoire. I wish you all a very happy International Women's Day. God bless you all. Thank you.